What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about configuring Azure Site-to-Site VPN for your on-premise environment. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is create a resource group. So we need to log into your Microsoft Azure portal, and within here, we need to locate resource groups services or resources, right? We're going to click on create. And from here, we're going to type in our resource group name. This is what I provided, site-to-site VPN. Once you provide the name, we're going to click on review, press create. It's going to validate, it passed, and then click on create. Boom, our resource group is completed. So our next thing that we need to do is create a virtual network. So locate your virtual network resources. Click on create. From here, we need to select our resource group. So click on the drop-down menu and pick the new one that we created together. And then provide your virtual network a name. I gave it this, pretty simple. And then from here, we're going to click on next. For the security, I left it as is. Click next there. For the IP address, you're going to provide an IP address as well as a subnet. I gave it a subnet of /24. Later on, I changed it to a /28, but it really depends on your environment. Once you pick your subnet, make sure you change the IP address range. Click next. I didn't add any tags, so I clicked on next, review plus create. So just click on create. It's going to start deploying, creating, and once it's done, it should take you here. And underneath the status column, it should say created. Now, next thing that we need to do is create a gateway subnet. So what you're going to do is go inside that new virtual network that we just created, go inside settings, subnets, and then click on gateway subnet. From here, we're going to provide a subnet address range. And like I said before, I changed the subnet range to 28. But you're able to configure it the way that you want it within your environment. And then once you make your changes here, click on save. Like I said before, I made changes to the default. I did pick a /24, but I changed my mind and did a /28. Now, next thing that we need to do is create a local network gateway. So locate the local network gateways resource. And from here, click on create. We're going to click on the drop-down menu to pick our resource group. And make sure you pick your region, provide it a name, and then give it an IP address. Now, the IP address of your local network gateway would be the IP address of your ISP. That is your ISP public IP address. For me, I'm doing it on my local network, so I'm going to get my public ISP IP address that my router is providing me, so I added it here. Once you provide your IP address, we need to add IP spaces. So right here, I added the 192.168.0.0/24 because that is the IP address that I'm using on my local network. I have different VLANs as well as DHCP scopes. So I'm going to add it on here. For now, I just added this one. And then once you're done, we're going to click on review plus create. Validation has passed. So click on create. This takes some time. Once it's done, the status column should say okay. Now, next thing that we need to do is create a public IP address within your Azure portal. So locate the public IP addresses resource and then click on create. For the resource group, you're going to click on the drop-down menu and pick the resource group that we created earlier. We're going to provide it a name. And once you're done, we're going to click on review plus create. Validation has passed. Click on create. And again, it takes some time. Once the deployment is completed, underneath the status column, you should get a okay. So next thing we need to do is create a virtual network gateway. So within Azure, locate the virtual network gateways resource. Click on create. From here, we're going to provide a name. Select your region. Give it the SKU, and also select the virtual network that we just created. For us, it was S2S VN, site-to-site virtual network. The next thing that we need to do is provide our public IP address. We have one, so select use existing, click on the drop-down menu, and select the one that we created earlier. Make sure you disabled enable active-active mode. If you have an additional public IP address, you can enable it and just assign it there. For this video, I only have one, so I'm just going to disable it. Once you're done, let's click on Review plus Create. Validation has passed, so just click on Create. Give it some time. Once the deployment is completed, the status column should say OK. Now it is time for us to create our connection. So locate the connections resource within the Azure portal. Once you're there, click on Create. Select your resource group. Provide the connection type. For us, it is going to be a site-to-site. Provide a name. Once you give it a name, click on Next. Now for the settings, we need to select our virtual network gateway as well as our local network gateway. And then you're going to provide a shared key. Make sure you remember the shared key. Once you're done here, we're going to click on Review plus Create. Validation has passed, so just click on Create. And again, give it some time. And then once it's done, it should say underneath the status column, OK. Now, within my home lab, I am going to configure one of my servers with remoting and remote access services. So let's head into this environment. And I'm actually using a Windows Server 2022 standard machine, version 21H2. Now, on the server, open up your server manager. On the upper right-hand side, click on Manage. Click on Add Roles and Features. Click Next there. Next. Next. Within this section right here, we're going to locate remote access. So just give it a check mark and click Next. For features, we're going to leave it as is. Click Next there. Click Next. And for the roles services, we're going to select Direct Access and VPN. So give it a check mark. You're going to get this. So click on Add Features. Click Next here. Next here. Next here. I'm going to check Restart the Destination Server Automatically if required. Click Yes. And then click Install. All right, so it's time for us to configure our routing and remote access service server. So on the desktop, I'm going to click on the Start menu. I'm going to open up the Windows Administrative Tools folder, and I'm going to locate routing and remote access. From here, I'm going to select the server name. This is the server name. I'm going to right-click on it, and I'm going to pick Configure and Enable Routing and Remote Access. I'm going to click Next on the wizard. For the configuration part, I'm going to select Secure Connection Between Two Private Networks. Click Next. I left it as the default as Yes. Click Next. Automatically left it as a default. Click Next. Finish. And let it do its thing. Once it's done, it's going to prompt you this for the Demand Dial-Up Interface Wizard. So click Next here. Provide your interface a name. This is what I gave it. Pretty self-explanatory, right? Click Next here. We're going to do a VPN, right? Connection. Click Next. And for your VPN type, we're doing a IKE version 2. Click Next here. And then this right here would be the public IP address of Azure, the one that we created. So enter it here, right? That public IP address that we created within Azure, this is where you enter it. Click Next, left it as the default, click Next. I'm going to click Add, and I'm going to add the following static route. And once I'm done, I'm going to click OK. Now that static route is basically the same subnet or scope range within Azure that I created earlier. I'm going to click Next. For the dial-out credentials, I don't need anything, so click Next here, click Finish, and we're done on that part. So expand the server node, and we're going to go inside network interfaces. We're going to locate our new network interface and then right click on it and then go into properties. Within properties, let's go to options and make sure the redial attempts is set to 0. By default, it is 0, but just make sure. Go inside security, and within security, enable use pre-share key for authentication, and enter that pre-share key that we created within Azure. Once you're done, click OK. Now it is time for us to connect, so right-click on it and click on Connect. and it's connecting. Give it some time. Eventually, underneath the connection state column, it should say connected. So head back inside your Azure portal, and then within your Azure portal, locate your local network gateway, and then click on the one that we created together. Within here, go inside connections. Give it some time. Underneath the status column, it should say connecting or something like that, or disconnected. Eventually, once everything works, it should switch to connected. That is a good thing. Now let's head back inside our server. Within our server, we're going to expand the IPv4 node, and we're going to go inside static routes. We're going to right click on it and create a new static route. And for the interface, we're going to pick the interface that we created earlier. And the destination network mask, this is what I gave it, and I clicked OK. Now, this destination is basically the same subnet that Azure has. Now, it is time for us to test. How can you test this? So within my Azure portal, I went inside the virtual machines resources, and I'm going to create a new virtual machine. Now, for the resource group, I'm going to select the site-to-site VPN that we created earlier in the very beginning of this video, and then just make sure you fill all that information out. Your machine should be running, and you should be able to remote into it. So that's what I did. I RDP into that machine. That's the IP address. Now, what I did was this. Within the virtual machine, right, the virtual machine that we just created the routing and remote access services, I started a RDP connection with that IP address, with the IP address of the server, right? Now, let's head back. This right here, I'm actually using the public IP address to remote into this machine. On this, I'm using the IP address of the subnet 10.10.0.4. If I hit connect, I should get prompted to put the password. This is a good thing. Put the password, hit OK. Another good sign, click yes, and then bam, I remoted into the server using the IP address. How awesome is that? And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.